In this example, we are given that the lower end of a capillary tube of diameter 2 mm is dipped 8 cm below the surface of water in a beaker. We are required to find what is the pressure required in the tube to blow an air bubble at its end in water. And the data given to us is surface tension of water, atmospheric pressure and the value of gravity. Here if we draw the situation, we are given that inside a beaker, a capillary tube is dipped in water in such a way that its lower end is 8 cm below the free surface of water. We are given that this depth h is equals to 8 cm. And if we blow air from this side, an air bubble will be blown here. In this situation, we can say the maximum radius or the minimum radius in this situation which can exist for the air bubble will be equal to the radius of this capillary tube, because when it will start blowing, the radius will decrease, and as soon as it will become equal to that of the capillary tube, it will be minimum, and beyond which it will again start increasing. So we can say if there is a point A inside the bubble and a point B just below the bubble, and the size of bubble to be very small, because we are given that the diameter of tube is 1 mm. So the radius up to which it is required to blow the bubble is 1 mm. So we can say here pressure at point B will be on the water, it is atmospheric pressure acting, and at a depth h at point B, we can write the pressure will be P atmospheric plus h rho g. And at point A, which is inside the air bubble, we can write now to blow the air bubble, pressure at point A minus pressure at point P, which is the excess pressure inside, is 2T by R. Here, if we take the minimum value of R, the pressure will be maximum, which is required. Otherwise, we can partly blow it. So, in this situation, as we know the value of PV, pressure at point A, which is required, or it is through the air inside the tube, will be equals to 2T by R plus pressure at B, which is P atmospheric, plus h rho g. We calculate by substituting the values, we can see it is 2 into 73 into 10 to power minus 3 divided by, we are given that radius is 1 mm here, so it is 10 to power minus 3 plus atmospheric pressure is 10 to power 5, plus if we calculate h rho g, it is 0.08 into 1000 multiplied by 10. If we simplify the result, in this situation, this will be 146 plus 10 to power 5 plus this will be 800. So, on further simplifying, this will be 946 plus 10 to power 5. So, numerically, it can be written as 1.00946 into 10 to power 5 Pascal. This is the pressure required inside the tube to blow the air bubble. That will be the answer to our problem.